tactile as opposed to being more authoritative and top down. So in the last few years, I mean, I can share hundreds of examples, but I think the key ones that come to my mind is we've always found a lot of good work being done by us every time that the promoter or the counselors of the promoters have a mega image, you know, a mega vision, a big goal, and more certainly most of them have actually. It's we who temper it down at times. And when they have that mega vision or goal, then it's up to them to be counseled right and to be counseled appropriately and relevantly and to be able to say, fine, it's great to have that vision that extends 5 years, but can we also straddle that with a 3 month, with a 6 month, with a 1 year? Because all of us are living in extremely dynamic times. There are times when you can't see the end of the road or the curve ahead, and it always takes us by surprise. So are you also having a risk mitigation strategies while you're building this very interesting, big, hairy, audacious goals, to pick up the BHAG terminology that the consultants usually use? So whilst you have that goals, and I'm not in any way saying you temper that, but once you have that goal, can you also be a little sure-footed in your approach and actually make that happen with the right set of people? And you need to have a leadership set of guys, you know, who bring in the knowledge, the technical knowledge, the functional knowledge. And interestingly enough, I don't remember a single organization that I worked with where that was wanting, because that's always in place. It is always the complement of the leadership, how they can align well together and move together, that becomes a challenge. And it is always that at what point do we focus on what? And I think sometimes the organizations get a little caught up with flavors of the season. This is good to do. I've heard it. This company has done that, and therefore let's do that. So I think as consultants, our goal always is to focus the company right in the short term and to be able to continue to have them dream big and continue to have those long-term goals. And it's great to have that great number out there where the whole organization aligns to. The last point that I want to really focus on is, and I'm sure you'll all agree with me here, it's really not about the top team out there. It really is about the entire rank and file of the organization. The entire organization has to be communicated with where you're going, what you endeavor to do, what do you stand for, are you conscious about, your conscience is in the right place as you develop business. And once you do that, and once you communicate right, and once your people buy into that, we find that those organizations move with a lot more sense of purpose as opposed to a company where there's a diktat which is kind of sent down to the organization. And I think the energy that you find across the rank and file of organizations most often determines, you know, the success of the organization. Are you being able to retain the right talent? Are you being able to have the right policies in place? Are you being able to govern, as you call it, the entire, you know, organization rightly at every point of time? Are you also looking at that Gen Y or Gen Z, or I don't know what you call them, the youngsters who come into the organization? Are you tuning in to them? Are you tuning in to them and saying that, are we doing things right? If you look at your children, and all of us, I'm sure, have teenage and plus kids, they do things differently. And are our organizations equipped to handle that, you know, the ambiguity that they can handle and the dexterity with which they can do multiple things? Are we being able to motivate them right? Or are they coming into a duddy-fuddy organization and they look at some sharp role definitions and they get put off and they said, you know, this is not the place where I want to be. So how alive are you? How relevant are you? How nimble-footed are you, even though you're large? And how do you kind of ensure that your organization per se is not becoming a big, large, ungainly mass of people, but they are people who are being directed and, you know, given a right direction, and that they're all sort of moving together well. So I think some thoughts, and I think there are more than enough thoughts from my side. I'd welcome questions, and I welcome to build on this further. Thank you for the opportunity.
Thank you very much, Nina. Thank you for putting up, flagging some very important issues. if you are led well and you build a good leadership culture, that automatically means that the company begins to be governed well. If there is good leadership, there is then only good governance. So whether it's board provided leadership, CEO provided leadership, promoter provided leadership, whatever kinds of good leadership examples there are in the company, they drive good business goals, but at the same time, they also drive very good corporate governance. This thing you said about the rank and file, that becomes so important. You know, when you think about what do the people of your organization, the word you used was stand for, what's in their consciousness? Does their conscience also drive them? Then you talked about the purpose. Does that get ingrained in the people, the rank and file? What is the energy and the success element? All of those things are part of the HR firmament. And because those good HR practices are embedded in the organization, they almost translate into very good corporate governance. That's the relationship. Very well brought out, Nina. Thank you. I go on to Mr. Singh and would request him to give us his thoughts.
Thank you, sir. I think first of all, I should thank these organizers to have given me this opportunity to be among all these HR professionals. Is on, I hope. As Mr. Chatrath started very well, my compliments to you, and it is a good help for me also. Because opening batsman is always a difficult job. So she has done a difficult job and quite well. Now, I'll pick up from there, and very important, good leadership. And as Dr. Chatterjee also reinforced the same thing. And from my side also, let me again remind that if a technician or a supervisor or if a probationary officer in a bank or any other position is not good or not ethical or not effective, it affects its area, limited area, I will say. But when a CEO or a chairman or managing director of a company is not ethical or in that right direction, then it affects the whole organization. So that umbrella increases, the diameter of that umbrella increases as you grow. So definitely leader is most important. But fortunately or unfortunately, leaders do not come from heaven. They have to be only brought from, to start, the starting point is same. If he also, beginning he told that recruitment, training, I mean, somebody said in a very simple one line or two line definition of HRD and HR, human resource development is recruitment and training and development of a person to the extent that he can deliver to the best of his capability. Now this one sentence is simple to hear, but then when you go through the process, it is meticulous and very, very, you have to go into details. But it is a fact that if you start this first step and then build on in the second, third, fourth, you are likely to get the desired result. Let me give you one example, because again, as it happens, because I've also walked the talk throughout these 30 years of my experience in sale. I joined in 74. Initial 14 years was in maintenance system. I was sharing with some of the colleagues sitting there, I mean, Mr. Bharadwaj, I think, in the morning part of it, yes. And after 14 years, I was given opportunity to go to HR function, HRD rather, human resource development. And I stayed there for about 10 years, got a very good opportunity. And after that, I was pushed, I will say, because normally you will find that people from HR, they don't want to go to hard production units. So I will use the word pushed. To the difficult units and with a challenging target. And there I found that it is basically, people talk about HR is our first human resource, top human resource, but unfortunately, in practice, that doesn't happen every time. I am saying every time, because at times it happens also. That is why we are growing, our nations are growing. A lot of good things are being done from HR side, and it is being accepted by good CEOs and leaders. So there I found that when we talk about how this comes, actually when you talk about people, their potential,